feature that you don't have complete control over, or a telephone that you don't have complete control over. Network neutrality is already broken because you don't get to choose what the applications do. So the fight for network neutrality is also the fight against things like the broadcast flag, against the robustness requirements of technology, the fight against Windows Vista's crazy suicide note, and a much wider, debate. And I really think people need to think about mobile telephony.
Before some of you leave, some of you ask us other questions, I want you to think about that 2/3 of the founders of the app are here in the front row. John and John Perry, and one of the mentors of the founding of the app. And one of the best parts about having helped the found EFF is nowadays we have to do very little of the work. Because we have an incredible staff, we can't even keep track of all the things we do. And I'm really glad. I've been coming to Europe now for many years, going to Access for All and CCC-related events. And at each one of those events, people would draw me aside into a larger, more crowded thing. So when is EFF going to show up in Europe and start kicking some ass over here? And I'm really happy that we are finally to come over here and start working inside of the town as well as inside the most successful one.
I was just going to say, you're welcome.
Are there any more questions?
In addition to halting the illegal wiretapping, if there is a favorable settlement for the plaintiff, just how big a settlement could there be? Will EFF get a cut of it? And is there any possibility the plaintiffs can take over the company?
There's this funny thing that happens when the lawyers that many of them talk about, and there are. There are legal theories that would say, yes, you could imagine, a judge have a judge saying, okay, this is all in the body of the but in any realistic standard, the government is not going to let you.
I have an idea. If we all send copyrighted stuff over our phone line, we can sue NSA for copyright violation, which the government will never amend the penalties for copyright violation. There actually are some law enforcement and intelligence exceptions for copyright, but I think that they have to be like legitimate law enforcement or intelligence purposes. So the other thing is that there's a baseball stadium in San Francisco, and originally it was Pac Bell, part Pacific Bell, and then Pacific Bell was acquired by SBC, and so it was renamed for SBC Bell, and then SBC acquired AT&T and put their name, so now it's AT&T Park. So maybe it will be EFF Park.
I'm trying to work it out. There are 24.6 million residential customers of AT&T. And we estimate that each of those probably, yeah, right,